In this chapter, we're looking at correlation and regression. And the first thing we need to consider is the scatter diagram. When we're doing regression, we're trying to determine if there's a relationship between two quantitative variables, such as height and weight, or time and temperature. And so the first way that we do that is by looking at a scatter diagram. A scatter diagram is just a plot of the data where we plot the x value against the y value. Okay, so again, for each pair of data or for each observed value, we would plot its x value against its y value, just like you would plot a point in an algebra course. Now, in regression, we try to determine that one of our variables is going to be the response variable or the dependent variable. It's the one that we're trying to predict. The point of regression is for us to be able to come up with a model to make a prediction using one value and predict another value. And so the response variable or the dependent variable is the one that we want to predict. The explanatory variable or the independent variable is the one that we believe influences the other. For instance, let's say we want to know something about how well a particular styrofoam cup keeps a cup of coffee warm or hot. So what we might do to come up with the model for the time and the temperature is to, at several points, measure the temperature and note how long it's been since the coffee was poured into the cup. And then that way we can come up with our regression equation. So in this case, the explanatory variable would be time, and the response variable would be temperature. Okay. Now, when we look at the scatter diagram, we could come up with several different types of patterns for our data, and that's what we're looking to find. There are all kinds of patterns that we might see. We might see data that has a roughly linear pattern. Doesn't have to be perfect, but approximately linear. Of course, we can see data that has a nonlinear pattern. Okay. And then we might have data that has just no real pattern at all. It's just kind of everywhere. It just makes a fuzzy cloud. There's no pattern there, okay? But in this particular topic, we're looking for data that has approximately a linear pattern, okay? Now, when we talk about our data, once we've determined that it has a linear pattern, we can say that there's a positive or a negative association. If one variable increases while the other variable also increases, we say that's a positive association. Okay. So, for instance, an example of data that might have a positive association could be age and height of a child. Okay. As their age increases, we expect that the height of the child also increases. And so we see that here. One variable is increasing, and so is the other. Okay? All right, so we've got a positive association, or you can think of it as a positive slope. The association and the slope, they'll be the same. So when we look at this data, as we look at it from left to right, it is increasing. So we've got a positive association. We could also have a negative association. And so still we have one variable increasing, but in this case, the y value is going down as the x value is increasing. So we've got a negative association for this particular data. All right. So once we've looked at our data and we've kind of determined, yes, there is a linear association there, then we want to be able to measure how strong that linear association is. And we can do that with our correlation coefficient. The correlation coefficient is a measure of the linear strength of a relationship between two variables. And the correlation coefficient will range from -1 to +1. Okay, if we have data that has a correlation coefficient of 1, that means it has a perfect positive relationship between those two variables. If we have a correlation coefficient of -1, there is a perfect negative relationship between the variables. By perfect, we mean that all of the points fall exactly on a line. The closer we get to -1 or +1, the stronger the relationship. And the closer we are to 0, the weaker that relationship is. Okay, so data that has a perfect positive relationship might look like, it'll be difficult for me to draw, but something like that. Okay, all the points fall exactly on the line. Perfect negative relationship looks something like that. All of the points fall on the line, but that line has a decreasing slope. And then 0, we've got just that fuzzy cloud of data. There's no certain linear relationship there. Okay? Now you can practice guessing correlation coefficients by going to this site, and I'll give you an example. Okay? No, you can't just, pull a number out of the air, but we should be able to eliminate some values. For instance, in this first example, I can see that the association is positive, so the correlation couldn't be -0.7 or -0.86. And it seems that the relationship is pretty strong. So I would guess 0.86 for this one. Okay, in the second example, I would definitely say there seems to be a negative pattern. It's a little loose, so I'm going to guess -0.7 for this one. Okay, this one seems to have kind of a fuzzy cloud going on, maybe a little positiveness here. So I'll guess 0.34 for this one. And then this one is definitely a negative pattern, and it seems to be a stronger relationship than this other one that was negative. So we're going to say -0.86 for this. Okay, I'll check my answers, and it looks like I got all of those right. All right, so again, I'm not going to ask you just to guess what it is, but I could give you choices like these and ask you to guess. So you might want to practice a little bit using this website to make sure you understand what the correlation value says about the relationship for two particular variables.